This is the world's greatest wheelchair. Not only can it spin in place by balancing on just two wheels, but it can also go both up and down stairs. On top of that, there's some additional features that involve things like disco balls, train horns, spinners, and dual-mounted Nerf guns. Because all the features for this wheelchair came from the brain of this kid right here.
It was this.
His name is Cash, and Cash is quite possibly the toughest kid I've ever met.
You fell down?
Yes.
Let me see you recover. Get up. Push off. Push off your wheel. Now push off your bed right there. There you go. That's what I'm saying, boy. I could help you, but you wouldn't know that you could do it on your own. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Sometimes in life you fall. But guess what?
What?
You just pull yourself back up.
Yeah.
Come on, come on. Get up there. Get up there. Get up there.
And it doesn't take long to realize he's got a good set of parents who are there for every challenge.
When you get on that lid, you push. With everything you got. Ready? Go. Go. Pop your willy. Pop your willy.
There you go.
Pop your willy. Go. Go. Don't fall back. Don't fall back. Go. Push. Push. Both arms. Push. Push, push.
And especially there for every triumph.
Push, quit rocking. There you go.
There you go.
There you go. There you go. There you go. Don't go. There you go. That's how you get it, man.
In fact, Cash's story begins when his parents went in to get a routine pregnancy ultrasound and were told his spinal cord would never develop properly because he had a condition called spina bifida. And even though doctors said that 75% of the time pregnancies like these were terminated, Cash's parents refused. And so that refusal to give up despite the odds has been his story since the very beginning. And whether he's fostering his diehard passion for basketball or just challenging himself by ripping out more pull-ups in a row than I've ever done, you quickly realize he just doesn't waste time with excuses. And so once I learned about Cash, I was so inspired by his attitude and resilience, I knew I had to make my way out to Texas to research what it would take to surprise him by building the wheelchair of his wildest dreams. And since the key to a good surprise is a good disguise, we got right to work.
This makes me want to pen a rock ballad.
And nothing else matters.
Now transformed into Roger from the Wheelchair Supply Company. It's very nice to meet you.
All right, here we go. Well, hello there.
Hi.
My name's Roger. I'm from the Wheelchair Supply Company.
Research.
I'm doing research. How do you like this wheelchair?
It's good.
There's no motor on that?
Neat.
Okay.
Roger clearly had a lot to learn from Cash, such as wheelchair dimensions, wheelchair disembarkment.
Holy cow.
How to bomb a rainmaker.
Oh! Yeah. Wow!
And yes, even proper wheelchair motor size.
3.5. Not even Stephen Curry has muscles that big.
Stephen Curry.
Yeah, right there. Stephen Curry.
Stephen.
That's right. He's good at shooting a, what is it, a 4-pointer?
3.
Oh, 3.
What are you talking about?
Is there anything about your wheelchair you wish that it had that it doesn't have?
Like a cup holder.
That makes sense.
And if he just stopped there, this could have been my least expensive video ever.
What if it could go upstairs?
But we didn't. And it didn't take much to really open the floodgates.
Nerf guns? Cool glowing light.
Yes, every day. Chocolate.
What's your favorite color?
Purple.
Would you want a train horn?
Yes, a clown horn.
What if it was like a toot?
Hmm?
Like somebody passed gas?
Or just stick with clown horn.
Yeah, of course.
That's poor taste.
And with that, Roger decided not to push his luck any further, seeing as Cash had already given us 3 months of work, we'd have to compress down to a 10-second build montage. So a few months later, it was time. Just got word they are 5 minutes away. It's time to transform back into Roger the wheelchair salesman for the big reveal. And Roger was practically my alter ego now, so I didn't need any makeup artist. Oh crud. Kinda wanted one though. Let's freaking do this. The family arrived at what the kids thought was Roger's Wheelchair Supply Company. And of course it's designed to just be a boring old waiting room, but to Cash, nothing is boring. It was time for Roger to make an appearance. If he could just keep his face on.
My mustache has fallen off.
But there was no time to readjust.
Wait.
Oh, she just found one of the cameras. I just gotta go.
Dad, there's a camera.
Roger.
Well, hello there.
Good to see you again.
How are you?
Good.
What are you looking at over there?
That giant fish over there.
See the big fish?
It looks like a lizard.
It was time for Roger to come clean. I'm just gonna give you a tour of the wheelchair factory.
Yeah.
I also have something else to tell you.
Okay.
This isn't my real hair.
What?
This isn't even my real mustache.
What?
This isn't my real goatee. My name is actually Mark. I make YouTube videos.
I saw your boxes.
You've seen Crunch Labs boxes?
Yeah.
We have even cooler stuff here than the fish. Ready to have some fun today?
Let's go.
And Cash wasted no time in kicking off a self-guided tour. There he goes. Welcome to Crunch Labs. Yeah, flex those biceps. You remember how big they were?
Probably 19 inches.
Whoa, bit of inflation. Come in here, pal. This is the world's largest Nerf gun. This is like a pool noodle and a toilet plunger. Oh, what are you kidding?
Basketball.
You went right to that thing, didn't you? And the tour's going great. First try, give me some. Until we hit a snag that allowed us to get down to business. I think it'd be fun if we had a Nerf battle. The only thing is, we'll have to go up those stairs.
My dad will have to carry me.
Wouldn't it be cool if your wheelchair could go up those stairs?
Yes.
Can I show you something? Okay, I want you to say, move that bookshelf. One, two, three. Move that bookshelf! Okay, you stay here, pal. May I proudly present this 4 foot tall, gyroscopically stabilized marvel of engineering with two self-balancing wheels and a cup holder, AKA the wheelchair of Cash's dreams. Who's driving that?
A ghost?
A ghost, I guess. Don't move.
Donut.
You see the back, what it says?
Cash tab.
Because that right there, that's yours. Want to go test it out?
Yes.
And with safety always coming first, it was important we started slow. You ready to go forward?
Yes.
Good?
Mama, I was about to run you over.
I know.
But before long, Cash found his confidence.
What?
Okay, all right, easy. Now, in addition to the custom purple underlighting and the blinged out wheel spinner sporting the colors of his favorite basketball team, we cooked up three different modes he could switch between by simply sliding a different module down our custom rack hot swap system. The first was party mode, where flipping the toggle switch activates a linear actuator, raising the disco ball for maximum visibility, while the green button really gets the party started. The second mode is for the days when you need to navigate a crowd, because now the green button will activate the train horn. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. This mode also includes a PA system. You roll up to school and you want to let everyone know you're there?
Got a new wheelchair.
Yeah. As well as a soundboard hooked up to the loudspeaker, so he could play any custom sound, which would of course include the clown horn. But that's not all. Push that one. Oh, that's lowbrow. Sorry, that should not be on there. But then don't catch yourself sleeping on the number one requested feature, a custom 3D printed purple cup holder.
Hey, sit, bring me a drink of water.
What's the magic word?
Please.
There you go. And that cup holder's the perfect spot to hold a glass of milk he could pair with the contents of the secret under seat hidden stash spot. Chocolate! And as for Cash's verdict on Feastables, you got lucky, Jimmy. He likes it. And so before I introduce him to the third and final module, appropriately named Battle Mode, I had a demonstration for him. Ready to see it go upstairs?
Yes.
I've seen this done, but I wanted to wait till you were here to do it for the first time myself. And I might want to put on my seatbelt just in case.
Safety first.
Okay, now all I do is hit the stairs button. And when I do that, a set of tracks which are connected to the wheels via a chain drive are lowered into place by a linear actuator. And then you just tank tread your way up any set of stairs.
Peace.
You're going.
And while I'll take the blame for the most ridiculous modifications of this wheelchair, including the fart speaker and some others you'll see here in a minute, I'm going up the stairs, buddy. Check me out. I want to shout out the incredible engineers at Skiwo who've spent the last decade perfecting the technology required to make a stair-climbing, self-balancing wheelchair. Buddy, I did it!
You made it!
They've had so many setbacks and failures and challenges along the way, just like my buddy Cash.
I could help you, but you wouldn't know that you could do it on your own.
But also just like my buddy Cash, they've had the resilience to push through and ultimately succeed in making a positive impact on the world. And to me, that's what it means to think like an engineer. I got my Nerf gun!
Whoa! Oh, that is big!
In fact, it's why I named the toy company I started that has the express goal of teaching kids to think like engineers, Crunch Labs. It's because things are supposed to crunch and break and fail along the way.
All right, here I go. Not gonna lie, this is a little bit terrifying. But you know what? I trust in good engineering.
And so if I can get them to do more than just watch a video, and build something alongside me while pushing through those setbacks as I talk about the physics of what's going on, then the principles will really sink in. So if you want to have a ton of fun while building up that resiliency muscle in your brain so you could be more like my buddy Cash,
it works!
Just head to crunchlabs.com or use the link in the video description.
It's a little nerve-wracking at first, I'm not gonna lie, but then you get pretty comfortable with it. And now I'm back down! Is that cool?
Yeah!
While I was coming back, I noticed something though. I can't be shooting the Nerf gun and driving at the same time.
And that is exactly where the third and final mode comes into play. Battle mode, where the toggle switch now communicates with a microcontroller that activates 250 kilogram high torque servos, swinging yourself into action, at which point the green button declares war. Then when you're done, just flip the toggle switch back.
Okay, I'm bored, I'm bored!
Whoa!
Like nothing ever happened. And so like any good engineers would,
starting line up for the battle. Daddy, me, and Mark are over.
Heck yes!
We put the whole system to one final test.
Let's go!
Did one of you guys hit me in the ear?
Charlie, is that you?
Can you handle any more surprises?
Yes.
Can you handle one more surprise?
Yes!
Okay, come over here. And this was hands down the biggest surprise so far.
Introducing the Cash Cannon.
Because the Cash Cannon is not only a custom turret we designed, which foreshadows a huge announcement in my next video, but by using the iPad on his chair, he's instantly connected to a private live feed of Crunch Labs from anywhere in the world, giving him the ability to remotely aim the Cash Cannon until he finds me in the crosshairs. So whenever he's with his friends at school, and he wants some street cred by terrorizing Mark Rober real time with an overclocked Nerf cannon. That's just a thing he can do now.
Man, Crunch Labs is not gonna be safe from here on out.
Now, unbeknownst to Cash, hidden right under his seat was my one final mega surprise. But before I unveiled that, we took a little break, had a little lunch, and did a little science.
Whoa! 10 out of 10.
And that earned Science Bob more than just a simple round of applause. And how about a round of Nerf guns?
This is what you do for 10 out of 10.
And not only can this chair more easily travel off the beaten path than a typical wheelchair, and easily slide into the back of a car using any kind of simple board as a ramp, but it has a tall mode, which enables you to reach all those higher spots or finally dunk on your dad.
Oh. Yeah! Let's go!
And so as I let him get in a little driving practice ahead of the final massive surprise hiding here, his dad let me in on a little secret.
He wants to be the greatest basketball player there ever was, whether that's Paralympian or able-bodied.
And while admittedly that seemed insanely ambitious to me at first, as he talked further, I realized if anyone was going to do it, it would be Cash.
The motto for him from us is, my resilience is greater than my resistance, so we don't really have any resistance, because if there is any, we're gonna at least attempt. If we fail, okay, but we'll get right back at it.
Well, buddy, I gotta tell you, you know how I said that was the last surprise?
Yes.
We actually have one more surprise. Remember when I was at your house, you had two bobbleheads on the shelf.
Stephen Curry and LeBron.
So sis, open the pouch, see what's in there. I looked up to see who...
Stick it through a wire, man.
Who else are they playing?
The Lakers!
The Lakers!
It's today!
It's today!
So, after we leave, we need to go to this game. Thank you, Mr. Moss.
All right, buddy. Let's go!
Come on!
So we headed to the arena, booted up in party mode, so Cash could attend his first real-life Warriors game in style.
I want that disco ball.
And we were turning heads left and right.
Hey, I need one of those.
But the biggest reaction of all came from Cash when he saw his favorite player for the very first time.
Oh, there he goes. Hey, hey.
and sitting next to Cash was by far the most fun I've ever had watching a basketball game. And not just because in the end,
he's coming to get it!
Steph triumphed over LeBron in a hard-fought battle. And as we were leaving the game, I realized Cash turns heads no matter how he gets around.
Because he's one of those rare humans with such an infectious enthusiasm for life, who openly embrace the tough challenges as an opportunity to get stronger.
And so as we said goodbye, I found myself feeling equal parts grateful I could experience his incredible attitude of resilience firsthand, and hopeful he'd go easy on me with the Cash Cannon.
My favorite thing about this wheelchair is how the incredible engineers at Skiwo use the superpower of engineering to literally will something into existence that is now improving so many lives. And as it says on the box, my goal with Crunch Labs is to get you to think like an engineer. That means you know how to think critically and break a problem down into manageable steps. Thinking like an engineer makes you a better soccer player or a piano practicer or math studier. Because just like Cash, you're resilient and you know the importance of failing a bunch before you finally hit that breakthrough. So the way it works is every month a really fun toy comes in a box like this, and when you open it, there's a link to a video where you not only build it alongside me, but I teach you all the juicy physics principles behind how the toy works. And the best part of all is each month we randomly select one box to slip in a platinum ticket, and if it happens to be your box, then you're coming out right here to Crunch Labs to design with me and my team for a day. So if you want to unlock the superpower of learning how to create and build whatever you can dream up, just go to crunchlabs.com or use the link in the video description
and order your Build Box subscription today.
Thanks for watching.